Well, hello everyone. Welcome to EnjoyTheMusic.tv and EnjoyTheMusic.com live broadcast of CES Audio. Wow, that was incredible. I gave a big flame burst. So Merrill, how you doing?
Very good, Steve. Thank you for asking. How about yourself?
CES, I love this time of year. You know, Florida is in the mid-70s. All my friends up north are hating me. Haters.
That's wonderful. You get to see a lot of good products out there.
Yes, absolutely. And speaking of good products, for the money, you make some incredible gear. So why don't you tell everyone about it?
Would love to, yes. Thank you. I'm going to start with the Christine, which I'm going to lift up and show you. So this is the Christine preamplifier, which we introduced late last year. And it's done extremely well. It performs, as you had mentioned, exceptionally well for the money. And as much as we don't want to use cliches, it's turning out to be quite the giant killer. So we're very happy about that. We've got now a distributor for all of France, a distributor for all of Western Europe in the Scandinavian areas and so on. We have a distributor for all of Canada, and they are enjoying sales of the Jens Phono Stage, which you know, I think you can see it back there.
Yes.
As well as the Christine. They obviously look alike with just different names on it. But
well, I'm going to give everyone the beauty shot because I've got your website loaded. So let me go ahead and do that real quick. Beautiful gold color face. And why don't you tell everyone about the Jens?
Yes, the Jens is also one of those products that we came out with just from a pure sound perspective. We built it purely for sound and then took it to market after that. Based on the responses. Took about 7 years total to get it to market with testing, using different systems and styluses and cartridges and different turntables just to make sure we got the sound correct and not geared towards one piece. So most people who use it think it's a tube system, but it's not. It's all solid state. It has a wonderful temper and speed. That's my phone. Sorry about that. It has enormous amounts of detail that you typically never get. And it has 70 dB of gain. So for all those 0.1 millivolt moving cartridges, this is one of the best out there. And as you can see, Harry Weisfeld, who comes across hundreds if not thousands of phono stages.
Oh yeah.
He uses this and he claims that this is his words, not mine, the best phono stage I've ever heard. And so we're very pleased to have him supporting us in that respect.
Now let's go from phono stages to your amplifier, the Veritas, which has been incredibly well received.
Yes, so the Veritas is still going strong. We are about to introduce over the next year I don't have a name for it yet, but it'll be the double Veritas, but it'll be twice as good. Unfortunately, we're trying to keep the price down, but it's going to be in the twice the price range as well. And it will have it'll be significantly better in not just performance, but also we're trying to give the chassis a little more stylish look. So that will be very interesting. And then on the bottom line, lower down, we're improving. We have the Tyrannus, which is priced now at $2,500. And even though we have customers all over the world with that simply enjoy it, and we'll improve that as well as the Thors, which are priced at $4,800. But I want to show you one other piece here, which we're doing. And this is the segue to some of the newer products that will come out later in the year. If you can see this is, it looks like a
shiny and chrome.
Shiny. And that's the box. And if you look at the back, it's also very shiny.
Oh, all balanced. Nice.
Yes. We only make balanced products, by the way, except for the Jens. But so this is going to be a very interesting product. I started off with just trying to do a phono stage, ended up doing a preamp. So it'll be a preamp, a phono stage, and a DAC as well. It will be primarily a preamp, and they'll have a dual input. You can use it for volumes, but it was really built for those who buy amp.
Right.
And they just want to go from the DAC to the amp. So this will sit there. It'll be full remote control.
Oh.
And the biggest thing about this, and we think will be one of the very, very few, is the phono stage will be fully remote control. All the loading, the switching. It'll have moving coil and moving magnet.
And all adjustable remote control?
Yep. Yep. So you adjust your loading with remote control, right? Mm-hmm. So it should be a lot of fun. And it's the preamp will be pulling off the Cara preamp, which is also, you know, people love that preamp as well.
Yeah.
So we're pulling technology off that. But the adjustable, the remote control loading, that will be something that's quite new. We're using 6-layer boards to accomplish that.
Wow.
Yeah, so it's going to be a unique piece of equipment. It should be out over the next few months, so look out for that.
Okay. Yeah. And pricing, any idea?
It's a dual input, as you can see, and dual output.
Yep.
So not meant for everybody, but it's dual input, dual output. So this base unit will start at $2,000 with an external power supply.
Oh, and then they can just a consumer just add on bits, or
exactly. So you add on the phone for $1,000 and the DAC for $750. And it's a nice compact box. You can stick it on your desk or on your shelf somewhere, and it'll work really well with that. The big part is the external power supply. It's the same external power supply we use for the Jens and the Christine.
So that's convenient.
Yes, very good power, very quiet. And if you talk to our dealers, they don't like the Christine and the Jens because it's power cord agnostic. It doesn't care what power cord you put on it. Ah. Even the cheapest power cord, and it works just fine with no change.
I don't see a problem with that personally.
I don't either, but you know that's how equipment's supposed to be designed, that power cords don't affect it. So that's how we're designing our equipment.
Well, that's the way to do it.
Yep.
So what else would you like to talk about today?
That's about it. I don't have any math questions for you, but one thing I'd like to share with everybody is our next newsletter is going to be very interesting. We have a couple of things, one on bass and subwoofers. We'll be discussing that. And if you can pick it up, you can either go to our website or just send me an email, or even send you an email and you send it to me. And the reason I say that is bass always affects the treble and the mid-range. If you don't do your bass correctly, you muddy up the rest of your system. Mm. And if you have too little bass, like, monitors, mm-hmm. then the top end sounds good, but you're lacking all that bass. So it's careful thing. Below 500 hertz, it's all vibration. It's not directional, and, you know, it just vibrates. So you have to be very careful that it doesn't affect the rest of your sound.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what I'd like to add, my thought for the day, I should say, or the month, maybe.
And that, kids, is your thought for today. Sorry, yes. I just had to. Oh, God. Well, it's all about having fun. So I guess that wraps it up.
That wraps it up for today. It was good to see you on the green screen there.
Oh, well, it doesn't look green screen to everyone who's watching. Beautiful TV studio. Well, it's like Game of Thrones or any of these other TV shows. It's amazing what they can do with green screen.
Indeed, yes.
Well, thanks so much again. And let me give everyone the outro. I'll get it on to me as far as the camera goes. Hello, everyone. My name is Stephen Rochlin. This is enjoythemusic.com and enjoythemusic.tv, wishing you and yours, as always, to enjoy the music. So here's some music.